In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to animate these abstract shapes. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. We'll use a few different tricks to get this done as easy as possible. Alright, let's get started. As usual, we create a new comp, name it animation or whatever you like. HD resolution 5 seconds long. Then we create the round center shape, which actually is a rounded rectangle. So we choose the rounded rectangle tool, double click on it, and first of all, get rid of the fill. We use a stroke instead. Color white, width 2 pixels. We should name it, of course, center. Then we open the rectangle property. Go into the path property, disable constraint proportions and change the size to 60 by 60 pixels. And we set the roundness to 30. Awesome, looks like a circle. Then we duplicate the shape, name it ball, always name your layers, and we reduce the size to 50 by 50 pixels. A white fill this time, no stroke. Then at 8 frames, we set a position keyframe for the ball layer. That's when the two shapes meet. At the beginning, we move it to the right, out of the screen. I think I need to fit the screen size to make it completely visible. At 24 frames, we move it to the left, to around 700 pixels. We want the center shape to stretch out with the ball. And we want the right edge to stay in place. Even if we moved the anchor point to the right edge, it still would expand in both directions. I think the easiest way to solve this is to add an expression to the anchor point property. A equals, then we use source rect at time, semicolon at the end, next line, square brackets, a.left plus a.width, comma, a.top plus a.height, divided by 2. This expression makes sure the anchor point is fixed to the right edge of the layer at all times. I think I messed up the position. Yes, we need to set the Y value back to 540. Perfect. Next, we add a size keyframe at 8 frames. Then go to 24 frames and adjust the X value. And it works exactly how we want it to. Awesome. Then we select all keyframes, open the graph editor to adjust the speed curves. We select both speed curves, which lay on top of each other, and slow down the end of the animations as far as possible, and speed up the beginnings as much as possible, which means both animations have the exact same speed. We move one frame to the right to 25 frames and set another position and size keyframe. Then we go to 40 frames and copy and paste the keyframes we set at 8 frames. We select the 4 new keyframes, open the graph editor again, and basically invert the speed curves. The position one, and this almost hidden red one, which is the size. Let's see. Awesome, that's the beginning. One more time. Now we add the big shape. This time we use the ellipse tool. Double click on it. Let's name it Shape Big. We use a radiant gradient as fill. But first of all, we better change the size to 800 by 800 pixels. Activate constraint proportions again, then the gradient colors. A grayish red and very light cyan combination. Looks nice, I think. Let's adjust the ramp position. Awesome. We move the layer to the bottom. This time we want the anchor point to be on the left edge, to let the shape grow towards the right. We add an anchor point expression again. The same first line, A equals source rect at time, semicolon at the end, then square brackets, A.left, comma, A.top plus A.height divided by 2. And the anchor point is still in the center of the comp, but move the shape to the right. We need to move the position 30 frames to the left though, to align it with the left edge of the center shape. Next, we set a size keyframe for the big shape at 48 frames. 40 frames, we set the size. Let's actually go to 40 frames and set the size to 0. Let's move the start point to 40 frames as well. And the end point of the ball layer, as they replace each other. At 60 frames, we set it to 720. We want it to bounce back a little. At 84 frames, we set another size keyframe. We select the first three keyframes, open the graph editor and smooth the animation. Starting pretty fast, and then slowing down. Let's check it out. Yes, looks good. Next, we want to rotate the shape, but around the center and not around the left edge. So we add a null object, which is right in the center, and link the big shape to it. Let's adjust the start point. Now we're able to rotate the shape around the center. Let's do it. We add a rotation keyframe at 48 frames. At 65 frames, we set it to around 135 degrees. At 84 frames, the shape swings back to around 60 degrees. We select the keyframes, open the graph editor once more, and smooth the animations. The highest speed should be in the middle parts, slowing down towards the keyframes. Let's check it out. All right, next we duplicate the shape and the null. Move them above. And let's rename the shape into shape small. And let's reduce the size to 250 at 48 frames. And 175 at 65 and 84 frames. Let's open this rotation property as well and move these two keyframes 2 frames to the right to offset the animation a little bit. Then let's change the rotation of the small shape at 65 frames to around minus 90 degrees and at 84 frames to minus 60 degrees. So it kind of counters the rotation of the big shape. Next, we subtract the small shape from the big one. We hide it, then select the big shape. Go to the Effects and Presets window to add a set matte effect. We take the matte from the small shape and invert the matte. Awesome. Let's take it one step further. We duplicate the small shape, move it to the bottom, make it visible, and add a set matte effect to it as well. This time we take the matte from the big shape and invert the matte again. Finally, we need to let the shapes disappear again. We go to the end, make sure all keyframes are visible, and set the rotation of the upper null to around minus 275, of the lower null to 360 degrees plus around 148 degrees. So they rotate in opposite directions. At the same time, we scale them up, the small shape to 2500 pixels, then the big shape to 5000 pixels. And there's a second small shape we need to scale up, of course. We select these last keyframes, open the graph editor, and slow down the beginning as much as possible. And speed up the end for each property. So the animation speed is highest right at the end. Let's see. Awesome. I think this would be a nice last frame. Let's set the end here. Hope this was helpful. Check out the links in the description. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye guys.